All right, so we're looking at the P55-CD53. Now, this is a step down from the GD65, but not much. What you are losing is one of the dual gigabit LAN ports, and then you're also losing one of the PCI Express X16 slots, so you're not going to be able to run Crossfire X or SLI, but you do get some more stuff back, including a ton of USB 2.0 ports on the back panel and more connectivity as far as regular slots go for PCI and PCI Express X1. You have three of each of those, so that's six extra slots in total, plus a PCI Express X16 for your graphics card. So if you're not a gamer, if you're building a workstation or you want to do it for regular computing, this is going to be kind of the board you want to look into. Really good stuff. Now, let's start by looking at it up here. 1156 is your socket, so it's going to be losing the Intel Linfield processors, your Core i5-750 and your Core i7-860. Those are going to work up on here. You have four DIMMs, so dual channel memory up to 1600 megahertz plus plus with overclocking, or natively 1333 is going to work on here. If you do use 4 gigabyte DIMMs, you can get up to 16 gigabytes of total memory loaded on this main board. Also, lots of SATA ports. You have six right here, 246. Facing this direction, so you can put a big graphics card there, and then you have an additional two down here, right there, and those are just gonna, you know, for whatever else you wanna use these for, eSATA ports, or to put extra storage, it's really up to you. Also, P55 chipset, nice little MSI cooler right there, kind of complements the rest of the board. It's metal, blue, and then the rest of the board is black. The PCB is all solid black. The one PCI Express slot is blue, which is pretty cool. And then the DIMMs are blue and black as well. So the board is very nice looking, has a lot of good stuff. Now, let's go to the back panel here, show you some of the stuff that you have back here. It's quite impressive to see this many USB 2.0s, but PS2s for your keyboard and your mouse, 10 USB 2.0 ports, so that's a lot. And then you have a 10100 1000 Ethernet right there, and then you have 8-channel audio, 7.1. You gotta keep in mind there is no SPDIF, and there is no, you know, either of the SPDIFs are on here. So if you want multi-channel optical out, you'd have to go with HDMI through your graphics card versus using, an SPDIF for your optical onboard optical audio. Also on the board, you have additional USB headers for even more USB. So you can do an additional four, bringing the total to 14 if you use this header and that header. And while we're standing right here, the camera's pointing in this direction here, your base clock buttons. So basically, if you want to go do a little minor overclocking, you can push that and increase your base clock. Or you can come over here and use the OC Genie button, which is also built into those buttons, but basically is a onboard processor that does automatic 1 second overclocking. Very cool system. You know, advanced overclockers are not going to be using it, but it's just another option on the board that you could give a try if you wanted to. You also have an onboard power button, and while we're down here in the obsolete days, you have IDE and floppy disk drive headers. You also got another one over here. Not sure why people still use those. It's also good to note that as far as power goes, for EPS 12 volt, it's a 4-pin connector, so if you have one of those new power supplies that has an 8-pin and doesn't allow you to take them apart to make it 2 4-pins, keep that in mind because it might actually hurt your build, and you might have the wrong power supply and you won't be happy when your system goes together. Besides that, we talked a little bit about the slots, but now I'll actually show them to you. Starting off here from the top, you have a PCI Express X1, an X16 2.0, two more X1s, and then you have three PCIs. So a lot of expandability. This might be a good system for a office system or a work server. I'm not sure. You could do a lot of stuff with this. You could put TV tuners in here, make it a media center. You could put multiple card tuners and make it a really big DVR. You can make it a media server with fiber channel cards and add a ton of hard drives. It's really up to you. You have a lot of connectivity. You have a lot of options. You have a lot of good stuff. It's also important to note that down here at the bottom, where'd it go? I lost it. Here it is. Zoom in right there. This is the ALC889A chipset. True Blu-ray audio right there. That'll do 24-bit, 192 kilohertz audio. So it's the true Blu-ray form factor now. Granted, you can only do the analog through here, but with a graphics card, you can send that out through an HDMI to a big TV, and it's going to sound incredible. Six channels of audio, no problem. Really good stuff. So very nice board. Nice price. Got to give them that. They gave it a good price. Good features, good reliability. If you don't know, it's got Dr. MOS, which is a pulse width modulation system versus having traditional MOSFET design. It's got one phase, one PWM, and basically that's what it uses. It uses up to 1,000 kilohertz switching frequency, so you're going to get very clean power to your CPU, which is good for overclocking. Again, the board is not really an enthusiast board, but you can overclock, and that's going to help you get a little bit higher than you would normally. But the price is right. tons of USB 2.0 ports, ton of expansion slots, really good stuff. It's the P55-CD53. If you have any questions on it, feel free to email me, and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on the MSI P55-CD53 motherboard, type in M452-6072 into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, I'm Albert.